Greetings to all of humanity. It's really a joy. It's a pleasure. It's my honor as usual greeting you and bringing this message of emancipation, whereby I'm pointing you to look no other place but to look inwardly to discover that your real identity is your divinity. And that is why I want to speak to you today concerning having no patience for ignorance. And all of that has to do with the kind of character that Abdullah was. And as we know, Abdullah was the black mystic from Ethiopia, Neville Goddard's mentor. And he taught Neville Goddard how to understand the Bible by reading it with the understanding of the Kabbalah also. And someone also said to me, the Zohar. Okay. But, you know, whatever it is, it was all about rising above ignorance. Okay. And if we are to look at ignorance, we would look at ignorance as sin, because sin is actually not knowing who you are, and that is the, you know, universal sin, okay, that everyone born in this world in amnesia, which is a state of forgetfulness. You know, none of us can remember, you know, when we was 12 months old, okay, double that, you still didn't remember. Okay, so we are born in amnesia, which is a state of forgetfulness. So that is our actually ignorance. So we do not know exactly who we are. We are seeking to know who we are. Now, this is how the ignorance comes in, because there are systems that have been set up to teach us what to think, but never teach us how to think. So we see that they have a school system that is saying that the world needs to be fixed, and they want to put the world in the right place. So basically, they come and they meet the whole of nature, the whole of creation. They met it being in, I would say, perfection, because the plant is in its rightful place. The animals are in their rightful place. But the only ones who are not in their rightful place is actually us. Okay? And we are to be the most intelligent. Okay? So here we see, as Abdullah was trying to teach Neville this intelligence to rise above the educational system, the political system, and the religious system. We see that Abdullah had totally no patience for ignorance. For example, when Neville went to him and was speaking about going to thought class, because that's what they told him at the shipping company. After Neville would have had this great and burning desire to travel to Barbados, and he had no money and he had no work. And Abdullah said to him, look, Neville, you are already in Barbados and you have gone to Barbados first class. That's how you went to Barbados. You are already gone. Even until Abdullah did that and Neville had no work and so on. And Neville saw that came to pass by that envelope under his door with $50. And back in those days, $50 was a lot of money. Even until he see that been fulfilled, he still allowed ignorance to get to his mind to tell him that he was going to travel third class, because he was told that by the people at the shipping company. And so I'm saying all of this to say that there's a certain language and a certain conversation that the system has been putting out in our ears for many, 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 many years. And there's so many people who still believe the conversation of the matrix. There's so many people still believe everything that was taught to us. And these are the people who need to understand, to be truly realized and self-actualized. You have to come to a place to realize that you are brainwashed and that you didn't really know anything, that you were actually mentally retarded, and it's not your fault, it's none of us' fault, and that, you know, we have to escape that prison. It's a prison of mental slavery, where they keep your mind in prison, but you're born here with certain faculties, and that is why sometimes when you come to know this truth, you're very impatient with people who are talking a bunch of ignorance, and you're showing them in such a simple way, because you've learned it in such a way and prove it in your life, and sometimes they fail to just listen. So Abdullah had no patience for ignorance. And I'm saying to you that you must not settle for ignorance. You must not settle for mediocrity. You must not settle for stupidity. Now, if you're doing something over and over and over again and you're getting the same result, and that result is not profiting you, are you going to continue? If you've been paying your tithes for 4 years, 5 years, 6 years, 7 years. You decide, okay, I'm going up to 10 years. You pay tithes for 10 years and you've never seen the windows of heaven being poured out to you and open to you and pour you out such a blessing as you've been told. And God said to challenge him. Then you're supposed to challenge God because you want to see and know that this God that you're serving, that you're believing, you're seeing the results in your life. For example, if a person can go to church and testify the goodness of God because they were able to buy a vehicle or build a house or acquire a piece of land, what about with people who own acres and acres and acres and thousands and thousands, hundreds of thousands of acres of land? What about the people who own airlines? Or what about the people who own so many vehicles? As a matter of fact, if I go further than that, what about the inventors who came up with the ideas? Who gave them the ideas? So if you're gonna count the blessings of God based on the things that are temporal and materialistic, then it means that there is a power that enables you to bring these things into manifestation, and that power is your great riches, and that power is your true essence. So whenever someone want to be ignorant of their own selves and do not want to accept themselves and do not want to love themselves and don't want to appreciate themselves, sometimes we have to come to a place whereby we are so impatient, okay? We're so impatient with this ignorance that we are willing to do things in our own lives to be the change so that they will see the change. So we are using that kind of ignorance to fuel us. So you can't be wasting time arguing with these people, which sometimes I used to find myself arguing even more with people and trying to show them this truth and trying to think, well, okay, they would see and they would accept the help. But no, you have to realize how deep the ego can really carry a person, how deep intellectualism can really carry a person. That's why you look at many countries where there's so much poverty and so much mediocrity, and you realize the people are well educated in terms of academic education. They go to school, many people believe, like for example, in my country, many people believe in an education revolution. But I always believe, and I will always maintain that kind of belief. I believe in an imagination revolution. So one is backward. One is keeping you backward and one is pushing you forward. So, my brother and my sisters, you can't tolerate, you know, ignorance by wasting time arguing with people and trying to convince people, because this is not religion, okay? This is not something that you're trying to convince people and you're trying to get people to conform to your belief or conform to your ways. This is a lonely path. Sometimes you might be the only person in your family who have to take this path. Okay, and then we see Abdul, I was teaching Neville Goddard all of these things, and I'm teaching you these things also. So you see, Neville said that Abdullah taught him in a way that he would refer to as rude. It means Abdullah was teaching him tough love. Abdullah wasn't being soft with Neville, he was telling him the honest truth. And I come to realize that when you find this truth, if you really, really want to share it, you're going to hurt people's feelings, because you're going to mash their corn and you're going to take them out of their comfort zone. Many people in their religious and poverty comfort zone because they love to embrace poverty and they love to use religion to cover poverty and believe that there's virtue in poverty and that God wants them to be poor. But here we see Abdullah teach Neville Goddard how to rise out of that kind of mentality by teaching them not to have any tolerance for ignorance. He must be impatient against ignorance. So we are to fight a war against ignorance by learning to think positively and always be optimistic in any situation, because we believe that God in man is man's imagination. And that's what Abdullah taught Neville Goddard. And that is why when Neville started going against what Abdullah would have taught him by listening to the voice of the media, okay, because in those days, everyone was speaking about the Great Depression. They were from 1926 to 1939. Everyone was declaring a Great Depression. Everyone was declaring, you know, bad news. But there was the very few who was declaring good news and affirming good things in their life. And so while many were committing suicide even back there in that time, because they were tolerating ignorance in their life, They were those who were becoming millionaires and multi-millionaires in the time of a Great Depression. So, my brother, my sisters, you have to realize that you're in a war, you're in a battle. So when you want to go on the internet and listen to the news talking about war here, war there, feeding you with politics, feeding you with religion, feeding you with intellectualism, feeding you with all of these kind of food that is not keeping you healthy and well nourished. And you, when you participate, you're giving your power away, and you're saying that you are very much patient with ignorance and you're willing to embrace ignorance. But you have to be intolerant against ignorance. Never stand for ignorance because you want to be accepted by the crowd. Never stand for ignorance because you want to be seen and heard, and you're trying to be a good person in life and looking for everyone to speak good about you. Even the Bible says, if every man speak good about you, then check yourself. Because there must be a lot of polarity, there must be a lot of opposite, there must be balance. So Abdullah taught Neville all of these things. But most of all, Abdullah taught him these things. Not by sugarcoating things for him, but being tough with him. You see, sometimes when you tell people, when you speak to people and you use the word like stupid, they get offended. When you use the word like ignorant, they get offended. When you use the word like monkey, when most people do not know, a monkey is a disestablished mind, an unorganized mind. Now we say all you need to do is organize your mind. So, my brother, my sisters, just as Abdullah had no patience for ignorance. So I'm saying to you, have no patience for ignorance. Okay, do not embrace ignorance. If you see your life in a way and you do not like what you're seeing, you can change it, change it, change your mentality, change your mind, change your life. So my brother, my sister, this is the best encouragement I can give to you. Do not embrace ignorance. Do not embrace poverty. Do not embrace mediocrity. Do not embrace limitation. Believe that God in man is man's imagination. Put your imagination to work to create your reality consciously. Because the Creator is in each and every one of us. That's why in St. John 1, he says that all things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. Everything that was made was first imagined, and everything else that ever going to be made and that would ever be made, it must first be imagined. It must first be a thought. It must first be an idea. It must first be imagined. That's why no one can tell you anything that was done in the Bible from the beginning to the end. That was a false mental, a false psychological, a false thought. That's why we have to take control of our mind. I have no patience for ignorance. We have to call ignorance, ignorance. We have to tell people the truth, whether it hurt them or not. Ignorance is ignorance because we are born in ignorance. And it's very important for you to show them that we're born in ignorance because we're born in a state of amnesia. Okay, they can get angry with you if they can tell you something that they can remember when they were 1 week old, or 1 month, 1 month old, or 12 months, or even 24 months. But they can't. Only at a certain age they can remember. And everything that they've been taught was taught to them by someone. And it's time for them to think for themselves. So you have to take a stand and say, I'm not going to stand for ignorance. But you only can do it by taking action and become the change that you want to be. So action speak louder than words. So that's what Abdullah taught Neville Goddard. So my brother, my sisters, I'm encouraging you to be a doer. Okay, get in action, put things to work in your life and prove what I'm saying for yourself. Don't let me sit here and bring in this message to you using up all of my energy and you're not putting it to work. Remember, the golden rule of life is do unto others as you would have them do unto you. And that's why I'm doing this good thing, this good deed unto all of humanity, pointing each and every one to look inwardly and learn to create your reality consciously and have no patience for ignorance. Stand against ignorance. Stand against mediocrity. Stand against poverty. Because it is your birthright to live in abundance and prosperity. All around you is abundance. Claim the abundance now. So with that being said, my brother, my sister, I want to thank you very much, and I hope that you've been encouraged and you feel blessed and you're willing to put what I'm saying to work. Yes, it might be a challenge from the stand, but just as you would build your body, you have to exercise your body to build your body. So too, you must exercise your mind. Okay, it's all within. Okay, for example, you know, since COVID, I haven't gone to the gym, and all I do body weight. My body weight I used to build myself and keep myself. And what happened? My body have what? Muscle memory. That way I can maintain. You want to come back to memory. We are here to come back to memory, to remind you of who you are. You are the creator in flesh, God in flesh. So, with that being said, my brother, my sister, let me say again, I want to thank you very much for listening to me. And if you haven't subscribed already, I'm encouraging you to subscribe, to like, to comment, or to share this video. Also, you can follow me on Instagram at BlackMadGuru. And also, if you like to take part in my course, the Inner Sun Science and Technology, or the Inner Sun Engineering, it is for persons who donate $20 or more on my Patreon. And it's there on my Patreon. But there are information for everyone. It doesn't matter how much you donate. There are information for everyone. But I'm just saying the course, you know, for people from that amount. But there's so much information I have there. There are videos there that you can learn so much from. And these are not on YouTube, okay? So you can go there and you can really feast. So, and then when I finish posting up those videos, which is 11 videos, I'm going to continue teaching the Inner Sun Science and Technology to each and everyone. No, until, you know, you learn to create your reality consciously, okay? You must prove it for yourself. This is what it's all about. So with that being said, my brother, my sister, I would like to also say to you, if you'd like to support this work, we have a PayPal. The link is down below. All the information that you will need is down in the description. So let me say peace, love you all, I'm out.